everything is connected, and our neighbors in Africa and the people where I live with, they also need interconnectivity to be able to participate in the new world that is doing this. Here I have got a story about the semantic web. I will skip that right now. It's where Tim Berners-Lee explains in a TED talk that he is asking for everybody to put their data on the internet. And that's something that we discuss in our course, The Evolution of the Internet, how we deal with these things. And of course, these are not technical questions only, mainly ethical questions and the questions of values, which is why we also be interconnected with our African brothers and sisters, because that's the life they're living, life based on value systems. Internet here in rural Africa. Here I'm speaking at the meeting of the village nearby in Chief Chikanta's area, where the community comes once a year to celebrate the new harvest. At the time, we were having the opportunity to discuss with the community about why is internet there. This community does not have electricity, no telephone tower, nothing. And one day, a couple of years ago, we were talking about it and there was a computer donated. Right now, the computer is somewhere on the table here and people are taking pictures and loading them in the computer, and the chief was actually complaining that he was not able to upload them. Actually, at that time, the internet was down, but the community was busy repairing it. But he would like to have it streaming on the internet because the preservation of the local culture is crucial. And let me give you also an idea of what the internet is for people that do not live in the West. If you look as a Western person to the internet, you're looking in a mirror. You're seeing yourself, you see the products that you need. However, if you don't live here, and you live in a situation like rural Zambia, but what about Laos or in the middle of Burma or whatever? There, you're looking through the window outside. So it's like if you put the windows open, you look to a different world. It's a good thing to learn from others, but you must also have your own content. And we live in an area where people speak Tonga. Well, there are very little, if any, sites in Tonga, talking about the Tonga culture. Crucial stuff. So, what about a rural internet in the rural areas? This page is left intentionally blank. We do not know. Who's living there to study? Who's coming there to help and to describe what's happening? Because this community lives in orality. That's the main mean of communication. Not by writing. I mean, there's hardly any pens around. Paper is short. Everything is short. So we talk. And so all that information is there, but there's nobody to record it, study it, or so. So, and that's in general. We do publish a lot from the Mache environment, but that's special. In general, there is very little research. So we might have all kinds of opinions about what is happening in rural Africa, but how do we know? We need to be there to study it. And at this stage, I think it's still a green field, all these studies. We do have to understand the context. And of course, people will say, these areas, they have all kinds of problems, and we're looking at towns. But we forget that more than half of the population do live in rural areas in Africa, and not only in towns. They work in orality, and they have a wonderful cultural heritage, which is intangible. Right now, not at all available on the web. And these are the issues that people deal with every day. Of course, there are a lot of other things like housing, electricity, and all these things that are mentioned here. Those you'll find in the communication very often. However, it's a very important area to look at and to work in. That's the context. We do need, there is another contextual problem that exists in Africa.